Anthony Riley, also known as Sleeping Warrior, is not only an illiterate guy who doesn't understand basic English, he also doesn't understand basic physics and science in general. Most of all, he's a liar, a con man, and a coward. I published a couple of videos about this little man lately, and they seem to have pissed him off so much that he decided to block me on his channel, or at least hide my comments on it. I found this out when I posted some comment on his latest video where he repeats all the nonsense he has been peddling over the last year about gravity and relative density disequilibrium. No one reacted to my comments, and no one liked or disliked them, something that I'm not used to. So I decided to look at the comment section of the Liar Riley from another channel of mine called Rebuilding Architecture. And this is what I got. Then I switched to my regular channel called Frank de Brouwer, and there they were. Both my comments were visible again. So the Liar Riley has me blocked. Why would he do that? In his eyes, I am only a spastic with a dog. However, it happened to me a few times now that in a comment discussion with him, at the moment I had him cornered, he went silent and never reacted again on that specific thread, although he kept reacting to other comments. In my comments, I make it a point to use no insults, and the rudest thing I have done so far is to show a picture of Onslow, a character from the comedy series Keeping Up Appearances, whenever it was about the Liar Riley. And, of course, I call him a liar, just as he does all Globers that don't agree with his silly notions. So now I cannot react to his stupid videos anymore in the comment section, and I'll have to do it this way. I'll try to make this a brief one. In the video, More Science Denying Ballers Misrepresent RDD, he published the usual nonsense about relative density leading to a vector with a direction and a magnitude, stating that the direction is toward the denser medium. In the comment section, he adds even more nonsense to his repertoire, like that Archimedes' principle is incorrect in current physics, that dividing one density by another not leads to a unitless ratio, but to an expression that does indeed have units of measurements, direction and magnitude. And he makes some ridiculous calculation of lead balls in mercury, totally ignoring Archimedes' principle and clearly working towards an outcome every toddler could have guessed, because every toddler knows how Archimedes' principle works. The lead ball will rise. And so he blunders on and on. You can pause and read my comment, so I won't have to explain all of this all over again. Let me summarize my problems with the whole concept of RDD as presented by the Liar Riley. First, you have to believe that when you divide a quantity with a certain unit by a quantity with the very same unit, you get a ratio, not only with the unit, but with a unit that is completely unrelated to the first unit. So if you divide kilogram per meter cubed, that's density, over kilogram per meter cubed, that's density again, you get kilogram meter per second squared, that's force, or meter per second squared, that's acceleration. He doesn't even make clear what the results of his division could be. Then you have to believe that dividing by zero, even though it gives an error on every calculator on Earth, in real life is possible. So you have to believe that 5 divided by 0 equals 5, because, according to the Liar Riley, dividing by 0 means that you haven't performed any function at all, so 5 still stays 5. You also must believe that 5 divided by 0.0000001, a number very close to 0, equals 50 million, a number only slightly less than 5. You also have to believe that a negative number is a number smaller than 1, although you also have to believe at the same time that a number greater than 0 is a positive number. Then you have to believe that the direction of the force is in the direction of the greater density, although there is no greater density when the object is denser than the medium, and or when the medium is isotropic, that is, that it has the same density in all directions. Here the liar Riley, by the way, has changed his story once again from "the direction is determined by whether the ratio is positive or negative" to "the object moves in the direction of the denser medium." Even if it were a meaningful statement, it wouldn't be true either. The magnitude of the force, or the acceleration, no one knows, is determined by the distance to its equilibrium, calculated as its distance to the number 1. An object with a density of 50 in a medium with a density of 0.2 will have an RDD of 250, while the same object in a medium with a density of 0.5 will have an RDD of 100. The last RDD is much closer to 1 than the first, which means, according to the liar Riley, that it would accelerate much slower than the first one, implying a smaller force. In normal conditions, when the denser medium is under the object and the less dense is above, there should be, again according to the liar Riley, a force upward that is greater than the force downward, and the object would fall upward. It doesn't. Even his own interpretation of what he calls his calculations contradicts the conclusions he draws from them. Then you have to believe that gas has no mass, but gas can have density, which is mass over volume. Just as that gas cannot have weight. Weight is just another word for mass, according to the liar Riley, but with little g in it. Little g doesn't exist, so weight doesn't either. This is just about the only consistent statement in this whole pandemonium. If you believe all of this, you can perform his calculations without blinking your eyes and show the outcome to the public without shame. But still, you would be wrong. The only thing you would have achieved is this: an object of a certain density falls down in a medium with less density, because an object of a certain density falls down in a medium with less density. That's it. Anthony the liar Riley has demonstrated time and time again that he doesn't understand his own native language, that he doesn't understand the simple meaning of words. His reading skills are only slightly better than those of Donald Trump, who most certainly is illiterate. He doesn't understand basic mathematics. He even cannot operate a simple calculator. He doesn't understand science, units, vectors. Although his partner is a photographer, he doesn't understand basic optics. Geometry also is an alien discipline to him. Thinking in three dimensions gives him a very hard time, let alone thinking in four dimensions. You wonder what the liar Riley does understand. I guess he knows on which side the food goes into his dog and on which side the remains come out again. But I'm afraid that's about it.